The race to Alaska, a 750-mile race along a coastline that God has forgotten. Each year, a group of lost souls assembles in Port Townsend, Washington, an old frontier town filled with bears. From there, they will use what wits they have to sail their ramshackle vessels up a vile stretch of water called the Inside Passage to Ketchikan, Alaska, an old frontier town filled with bears. The ocean here is savage and offers a glimpse into the indifferent violence of the universe. 15-knot currents, a notoriously unpredictable sea state. Each wave here is its own god, and they are angry. There are no motors allowed in this race, nor is there any support team. Why is this a rule? The races themselves often shout this question into the night, but the night does not answer. The prize for first place is $10,000. The prize for second place is a set of steak knives. There are no other prizes. Everyone else is simply racing to feed the starving madness within them. But what propels them? Is it some kind of ancient insanity? These pitiful souls throw their bodies and minds into the chasm of destruction in the hopes for a few dollars or perhaps a set of steak knives. But still, one must have an appreciation for the race. There is a type of beauty to it, yes, but it is a pornographic and violent beauty. I think that God, if he exists, would be a cruel god, and the race to Alaska would be his finest creation. I find myself wondering, late at night, when sleep escapes me and the hollow void of my mind is laid bare, would I partake in this insanity? I am so safe in my life. Why would I risk that? Why would I go? Would I go?